Today, emergency workers in hazmat suits swarmed a railrunner stop, but it was just a drill. Action 7's reporter Laura Terrain is live in Bernalillo to explain why.
If you take the rail runner tonight, you can breathe a little bit easier. That's because just a few hours ago here at the Sandoval County stop, there were firefighters, policemen, military, SWAT teams, TSA agents, you name it, and they were all going to help you in an emergency. In a train emergency, information is critical in order to save lives.
How to evacuate people through windows, how to shut the train's engines down.
Now first responders are ready if terrorists target the New Mexico Railrunner Express.
Here today we have a situation in which there was a chemical gas released on the train.
Wearing hazmat suits, assisting 35 actors, playing victims, and putting the train on lockdown, the drill was no joke.
They're not just playing emergency, but they're actually treating it as if it happened.
And if the train derailed, like what happened in April in Fort Sumner, the different agencies would now know how to coordinate their rescue effort.
This may be one of the only times that law enforcement and first responders actually all respond to a scene like this, to be able to save lives in a critical situation.
This is the fifth full-scale operation in the Railrunner's seven-year history. In Bernalillo, Laura Terrain, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The Railrunner moves along a 100-mile corridor in New Mexico. Officials say these drills allow first responders to coordinate their emergency efforts.